That was no accident. I was drugged with sleeping pills. I was murdered by that person. That's why I took my revenge. It's only fair, isn't it? Idiot. I finally get to see you again, and it's not your fault. You didn't do it. No, I didn't. I killed that person. But that wasn't you. It doesn't matter. It might as well have been me. I can't believe something like this happened. The events of that gloomy, rainy afternoon that started this whole mess kept playing through my mind. Episode 2, Reunion and Turnabout. Hello and welcome back to Ace Attorney, Justice for All. June 16th, 3:34 PM, Wright and co-law officers. Hello? What depressing rain. Do you understand how depressed that makes me, do you? I guess. But actually, more than being depressed, I'm angry. Angry at that weather girl on TV. I think our little rainy spell would take a break with a stay of sun. Isn't that what the girl said? I'd stake my life on it. Well, it's the weather. But that's why I didn't bother to bring an umbrella today. What nerve calling herself a weather girl. She's going to hear about my $1,500 suit. About your case. Unless you're planning on suing the weather girl. I'm sorry. I thought that before we got down to business, we could have some friendly chatter. My name is Dr. Turner Gray. I'm a surgeon. Remind me never to end up under his knife. I'm here today because of this incident. Malpractice, a great surgical clinic. 14 inpatients lose their lives. Oh, you're the doctor at... It's really quite upsetting. Did you hear me? Upsetting! Yes, I heard you. I agree. It's quite upsetting, Dr. Gray. The one that screwed up was that nurse. It was her that got the medications mixed up and killed those 14 patients. And yet, Nell isn't good, and yet, that nurse had the nerve to go and die before admitting to her wrongdoing. She didn't even offer any sort of explanation to me, and this is the kicker. She up and has herself a grand old accident and crashes her car. Smash, crunch, instantly transforming her car into an accordion model. Oh. Accordion model, you know, the instrument. That's right, about a year ago, all the tabloid shows were talking about it. 14 victims of a medical malpractice, and the nurse's mysterious fatal accident. There were rumors that Dr. Gray had actually caused the crash. People said it was to forever hide the person responsible for the malpractice incident. Why would I? Now, I'm just going to say this once. Why on earth would I want to kill that nurse? She's the one who killed those 14 patients, not me! I think you need to take a deep breath, Doctor, and focus. More to the point, this case is over a year old. Why bring it up now? That's simple, because the situation is slipping out of my grasp. This just won't do. My clinic isn't seeing nearly as many patients nowadays. Do you understand what that means? It means they're not coming to my clinic. You don't say. If it were me, I don't think I want to go there either. So, what would you like me to do about it? I want you to help me prove I'm innocent. You do realize I'm a lawyer, not a private investigator, right? No, this is something only you can do. Mia Faye, you know this girl, correct? Mia? Why would he know her name? I heard you were working under her for a little while. Well, yes, I mean... Hey, wait a second. I worked under her? Yes, am I wrong? She told me, so I'm not quite sure if... Well, we worked a few trials together, but she went back to her hometown to undergo more training. Oh yes, I heard. It must be lonely for you. What? Wait, I'm not! She must be an extraordinary girl to handle such rigid training. Huh? I have an acquaintance who knows a lot about those mysterious, mystical sort of things. She's the one who introduced me to Miss Faye. Is Maya really that famous? And I've already set up an appointment. For what? What else? A channeling. I'm going to have her call the spirit of that nurse that went and got herself killed. Oh. Hey, I wonder what she's up to right now. The women of the Fae family have always been spirit mediums. It's because the power to communicate with spirits flows strongly through us. That's what she told me. I guess she's learned to accept her responsibilities and become an adult, even though she still looks young. Not counting training, this will be her first time channeling a spirit. So she gave me one condition before accepting my request. A condition? The condition is you, Mr. Wright. She said that she wouldn't do the channeling without first seeing you again. Me? And that is why I've searched you out. You want to see her too, don't you? But she came back in the last trials. Oh wait, no, this was 2 months ago. Okay, I forgot about that, it was 2 months. And so, that is how I ended up visiting Maya's hometown with the doctor. Let's take a drink. June 19th, 1:25 PM, Karain Village. So this is Karain Village, Maya's hometown. Hello? Why hello there? What an odd little girl. Hey, wait up, Billy. Huh? Someone else is coming this way. Nag! Clump! Maya, how are you? It's good to see you again. Wow! I didn't think you'd really show up! It's not that big of a deal. You made it sound like you were so far away. Well, maybe I exaggerated, just a little. It was only 2 hours by train. If I'd known you were this close, I'd have visited more. No, you're not allowed. I already decided, you know. Until I become an adult, I have to work hard and be strong myself. Oh, well, that's gonna take a few years, because logically speaking, you don't become an adult until you're about 20, and stuff like that, so you look about 16. Anyway, congratulations. I'm glad to hear training is going well for you. Yay, let's talk. Today's challenge. Looks like you finally become a full-fledged medium taking on your first job. Yeah, I don't think it would be this soon. But in this case, do you know the messy story behind it? Behold the power of the Mayor Intelligence Network. Let's see, 14 people died, but it was a malpractice on Dr. Gray's part, right? And to pin the blame on the nurse, he killed her in what appears to be a car accident. Huh? So what is this Mayor Intelligence Network anyway? The tabloids. That's what I thought. I'm just pulling him late, Mick. What really happened is the exact opposite. I heard all about it from Mr. Gray. Dr. Gray. Oh, come on, Nick. I want to take a crazed killer as a client. That's too scary even for me. Yeah, I guess so. So, this is your hometown, huh, Mayo? Yep, Karain Village, but I've heard people call this village Medium Valley, too. Interesting. So, everyone that lives here is a spirit medium? Pretty much. Most of my ancestors were too, I think. That's probably true, since that Fae ability to communicate with the dead is so strong. Actually, only the women of this village are mediums. So what do the men do? They usually work someplace outside the city. Village, sorry. Same thing technically, it's just a city is more a lot of buildings and yeah. Oh yeah, I wanted to ask you about the girl I saw earlier. Do you know her? Oh, you mean Peely. Peely? Peel Fae. She's my cousin. Hello. Isn't she adorable, just like yours truly? Well. Cousin. Wait. That means, is she also a... Yep, she's a medium, too! No, she looks like a small... I'm sorry. Peely's a real genius when it comes to channeling. I see. I hope I didn't scare her when I tried to talk to her before. Nah, it's not you. My aunt drilled it into her head that if a suspicious-looking person tries to talk to you, run away! Suspicious-looking... It's the hair. Well, you're not wearing training clothes, for starters. Of course not. Peely is my aunt's most valued treasure, so she's not allowed to go outside of town. She doesn't know how much about the world out. She doesn't know much about the world outside of Karain Village. Aunt? Peely's mother is my aunt. Duh. Come on, Nick. Well, Nick, I've got to get going. It's about time for the channeling to start. Huh? Oh, yeah. I'm doing the channeling in my house, so come on in, okay? After I'm done, we can grill up some juicy burgers. All right. Good luck, man. See ya. Well. At least she's still the same perky Mayo. Let's examine the place, see what's around. What's this? A giant rock that seems to be reaching for the sky. Its origins are written on a beat-up old sign. Who said the giant rock has claimed the Karain boulder? There's a really complex explanation written here, but long story short, it's a big stone for spirits to live in. Or something like that. It's an old style phone booth. I can't say it fits in with this area too well. My cell phone doesn't get reception up here, so who knows, I might need it later. The biggest, most elegant of the buildings I can see from here. This is Fae Manor, the place Maya calls home. It's easy to be overwhelmed by its presence. Oh, damn it. I was gonna, like, see if I can see what that mountain's called. Meditation room. Ah, Mr. Wright, I'm so glad you showed. Some nice weather we're having today. Aren't you happy? No, not at all. The stupid weather girl made the wrong call again. It will rain cats and dogs today, she said with a straight face. I can't believe they all allow such misguided reports. Looks like talking about the weather with this guy is just asking for punishment. But anyway, this is a splendid matter. This is going to be perfect for raiding down the ghosts of hell. No argument there. It's hard to believe that this is Maya's house, though. I was given a guide map to this building. Here, Mr. Wright, I have a copy for you, too. Yay! Oh, would you like to have a look at my badge? Wanna have a look at my badge, mate? See, have a look at this. Look, here's my attorney's badge! Are you trying to compete with me in my profession with that piece of scrap? I am a surgeon. Compared to you lawyers, I'm practically a saint. Yes, well, I don't exactly have any patients right now. But listen good, I'm not the one that made the mistake. This doctor needs his head examined. Oh boy. Okay, talk. What are you going to do once the nurse spirit has been called? Isn't it obvious? I'm going to have her write a signed confession. A signed confession? Yes, a confession. Pay attention. I'll have her write this. 1 year ago, on May 2nd, 14 patients died due to my negligence. And then on May 24th, I fell asleep at the wheel and died in a car accident due to my further negligence. I'm sorry, and I apologize for being negligent. That's what I'll have her write. Write a confession. The rain falling on my soul can finally stop. Oh, I see. She's a ghost. I'm guessing that's what the starting bit was. I was drugged. I'm guessing they do end up calling her, but that's what she says. So, how did you hear about Maya Faye? I heard about her from an old acquaintance, a girl studying the occult at the college. The girl introduced me to this village. This is the home of the Karain School of the Channeling. The home, huh? And Miss Mayer is a daughter of the master right here. Master? Anyway, do you see that door? That's the room where people and spirits meet. Miss Mayer's aunt is in there right now. Would you care to meet her? Sure. Okay, what's my new way? June 19th, Fae Manor, Winding Way. Wow, the garden is really breathtaking. Someone put a lot of love into it. What is that over there? Is that an incinerator? It looks a little out of place in a garden like this. If we're able to explore this place, does that mean there's going to be a murder here? Because I'm a little worried there's going to be a murder here, because we're exploring more than usual. no clues. See, there's a fucking incinerator. It's a small incinerator. I don't think garbage trucks come all the way out here to a little village like this, so every family has to burn their own trash. It's a really old urn. The ashes of a person long dead are inside. It looks like something with a long history. Other than that, it's not very interesting, so time to move on. It looks like there's a room over there, too. Peaceful feeling is emanating from it. Oh, there's a room? I'd love to go visit it. Side room. June 19th, Fae Manor, side room. So, this is the side room. Looks like it's more of a break room. There is a bedding spread out on the floor. It looks like someone's sleeping in one. I shouldn't disturb them. So, if I remember right, the last case in Ace Attorney 1 was in February. So it's been... how long? Probably around 4 months since then? So that means it's been 6 months since the start of this game. But they went back 2 months. Okay, let's go back to where we were last time. Ooh. Channeling chamber. Sexy. Wow, it's such a strange atmosphere in there. These flickering lights. I guess they're candles? Good sir, who may you be? My name is Phoenix Wright. Oh, you must be that good sir. Good sir? Is she talking about me? You are a lawyer, are you not, good sir? I have heard much about you from Mystic Maya.
Is it, sir? Mystic Maya.
I am Mystic Maya's aunt, Morgan Fay.
That sounds more like a guy's name, no offense. Or Morgana, maybe? I don't know.
Nice to meet you. Ah, I had wanted to speak with you about a certain incident, good sir. It would seem that perhaps you asked too much of Mystic Maya in performing your duties. Most unbecoming, I'm afraid.
Huh?
Don't tell me you've already forgotten. That it was not for Mystic Maya and her assistants, you would surely not have won.
First a girl that runs away, and now an old lady who says I stink at doing my job. Why did I become the poster boy for how not to make a first impression?
The past is the past, though. Let us speak of the present.
Ah, thank you. Talk. Maya. So, why do you add Mystic to Maya's name? Isn't that a little strange?
Good sir!
Yes?
How dare you be so rude and disrespectful towards Mystic Maya?
I'm sorry.
She must be addressed by her proper title, good sir. You must call her Mystic Maya.
So about Mystic Maya?
It is the blood.
Excuse me? Blood?
Mystic Maya carries the blood of the master. In actuality, she is the only one remaining.
Only one remaining? What's that supposed to mean?
Mystic Maya is the last of the righteous heirs of the Korean channeling technique.
Okay, then where do you stand?
That is a little more complicated. Although a woman of the Fae family, I am merely a member of the Branch family.
Branch family? What's that?
It is as it sounds. For a member of the Branch family, no matter her spiritual power, she can never become the master of the Korean school.
So, how strong are you?
It is a shame, however, I will admit. I cannot even begin to compare the loneliness of my power to their masters.
So that's how it is.
So today's channeling will be your first?
Yes, good sir.
Because the spirit of a person who dies in a traffic accident is usually very strong. It is usually easier to call that person to our world.
Traffic accident, indeed.
Channeling will take place here in the channeling chamber, good sir. As you can see, I am in the process of preparing.
So, this room is the channeling chamber?
This place where a spirit medium speaks with those who have departed.
I don't suppose you'd mind if we observe the session.
Do not even think of such nonsense. Only the medium and the client may enter here. The secrets of the Korean technique could not be seen by just anybody.
That never stopped Maya from doing it in front of me before.
It is also for your safety, good sir. If something were to go wrong, that is why, while channeling is being performed, that heavy door is securely locked.
Oh, that's why the lock is for.
Oh, yes. I wonder if you have yet to meet Pearl, good sir.
Pearl?
She's an adorable, ancient young girl.
Pearly? Oh, that odd.
She's my daughter. Now then, what was it you were about to say?
What a cute daughter you have.
A pure-hearted... Pure heart that knows not of the evils in the world is a powerful thing, good sir. Please refrain from affiliating with her, I request.
Well, it's not like I had the chance to anyway.
I must insist and stress that you not let it occur.
Okay, I get it. Sure. I guess we're moving somewhere now. Hi. Yep. Back to Whining Way?
Hey, you! Hold on, now! The gal's got a few questions to ask!
I'm sure I've heard that southern accent sound before.
It's you!
Oh, well, I'll be! It's Mr. Phoenix Wright! How you been? Haven't you seen you in a while? What, a year?
You are,
It's Lotta Hart!
You're Lotta Hart, right?
Bingo! I'm the one and only paranormal photographer, Lotta Hart!
So I guess you're still at it being a photographer, I mean.
Of course! And today I'm gonna get myself a real scoop! You wait and see.
Oh, that's right. This ain't no time to be wasting time. The channeling's about to get started. Is it that time already?
We all should hurry up and get to the meditation room. What are you waiting around for? Come on!
Lotta Hart, huh? I've been judging her harshly because of that case, but I guess looking back, we had some good times too. the framing of Miles Edgeworth. June 19th, Fey Manor, Meditation Room.
We will now begin the channeling. Mystic Mayor and Honored Guest, please proceed into the channeling chamber.
With this, I can finally swat all those pesky flies once and for all. You hear me? They won't be able to say a single bad thing about me after this. And with my reflexing hand, I will control everything, even the weather girl. You would love to hear them apologize, wouldn't you? Wouldn't you, Mr. Wright?
Me? Oh, yeah, I sure would.
Mystic Mayor,
do you have the channeling chamber key?
I just changed our voice for a second.
Yep, right here. That is most unsatisfactory. That is most satisfactory. That key is one of a kind, so please take good care of it.
I'll be fine. I'm Morgan. I won't lose it, trust me.
Okay, Dr. Gray, let's get this started.
Finally, let's go!
This is gonna be, a little weird. Click.
Now, let us wait patiently out here for them. Please have some lovely bitter green tea and jaw-droppingly large strawberry desserts.
Hold on now, Granny.
Granny?
How come we aren't allowed in that room?
Dear madam, you have an impressive grasp of English. From where did you learn it?
What? I'm from the heart of the heartland.
Is that so? Then I humbly request that you return to this heart of the heartland.
What are you...
This is Karain Village.
If you cannot follow our traditions and rules, we request that you leave.
Sorry. Oh, she shut Lozier up. Now that's impressive.
Now then, let us wait.
1 hour later. Fucking hell! Of course it doesn't! No!
Hey now, what was that?
It came from inside the channeling chamber.
Hey, that's a gunshot! Excuse me? I've heard that sound before. It's a gunshot. I bet my afro on it.
Mayor, Mayor's in there.
Break into the chamber.
Well, Mr. Lawyer, what's the plan?
What else? We're going to break in.
What? But there's only one key and that kid's got it.
We're gonna have to break the door.
We're gonna have to break the door. Is that alright, Miss Faye?
Well, yes, but there's one matter. That is...
Don't try to stop me.
You can send the repair bill to the Riding Co. law offices later.
Yeah, now that's what I call being a man!
What happened?
Oh, fuck! Dr. Gray!
I... I was murdered.
Mayor?
That man... murdered me. So I killed him.
Oh, shit. Oh, fucking hell.
So originally, I thought channeling...
Oh, why didn't I get it connected at first?
I thought it was going to, like, summon a ghost and it was going to talk, but no. I forgot how channeling works. The only reason mediums can do it is because they can host the soul. Their body has the power to host the soul perfectly. And this soul, since it was so very strong, it was easy to get, and since it had so much revenge, it killed him. It didn't care what happened to Maya, it killed him, no matter what. Oh, fucking hell.
Maya's gonna go to prison for this.
What?
Look, at a time like this, times like this are perfect for snapping up shots. But anyway, what's going on here?
Miss Gal, is she Mayor?
Step away from there!
Please, leave this area to me. Go quickly and inform the police.
But... Hurry! Before there are more victims here.
Hey, let's go, city boy. Leave this to Granny.
Oh, shit.
This game gets to me, okay?
My cell phone doesn't get reception way out here. Oh, God. So I ended up using the phone booth to call the police.
I wonder if I hadn't checked the phone booth when that happened.
And? They're on their way. That's good. Lordy. I saw a general mysterious phenomenon. She seems really on edge because of all this.
Not that I blame her. I'm scared to death by what's going on.
Whew.
Hey, mister. That gal, Maya, she wasn't the one that pulled the trigger, was she? Oh, yeah. Luna doesn't know that when Maya is channeling her whole physical appearance changes. Then again, weren't there only the two of them in there? I reckon she must have done it then. Luna, what do you know about Dr. Gray? Not much, but I did some digging. That's one gem with a bad reputation. Really? He was good at surgery and stuff, but his personality stinks like wet sheep. Sort of got the same impression myself. I'm actually worried about his surgery. He's real controlling. Soon as his nurse or patients don't do what he says, he starts hollering. Must have been real rough to work with him.
Ah, Mr. Wright.
Miss Faye, how's Mystic Maya? She's returned to this world. The spirit severing technique was successful. Let me see her, please. She is still unconscious. I humbly request that you wait outside for her recovery.
Guess I just have to wait.
The police are here! Come show to the rescue!
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Huh?
You again? Doing all the way out here, Detective Gumshoe.
It's actually kind of funny. I was in the area for a business trip, pal.
Well, time to check out the crime scene. I'll have to question everyone here later on.
So just sit tight, alright?
Why is he gritting at me?
Shall I show you to the scene of the crime, Detective Gumshoe?
My name isn't
Gymshoe. I didn't even notice.
The two of them went into the channeling chamber. I guess all I can do for now is see what everyone has to say.
June 19th, Faye Manor, Channeling Chamber. The police are busily running here and there, and I don't see Mayor anywhere.
Hey you, don't touch anything!
Look, I really need to ask you some questions.
Don't look at me like I'm some sort of uncaring jerk.
Tell you what, pal, I'll let you ask me a few questions, alright?
About Mayor.
I hate to bring this to you, pal, but the way things look now, that girl's the only one who could have done it.
Yeah, only Mayor and the victim were inside this room. After all,
the Mayor is...
You can ask more about her later, pal. Right now, I've got a job to do, and that's collecting evidence.
Detective Gumshoe looks like a real professional, and yet something about his expression still looks the same.
Now, there is one question I got. Where the fuck did the gun come from?
Because... Okay, Mayor had the key. Unless... There has to be more behind the Doctor. There has to be more behind Dr. Gray. I don't know what it is, but he's the only one who could have had a gun on him. They were calling a spirit. There's no fucking way a spirit can have a gun on them. Like, seriously, it's a spirit. And it was hosting Mayor's body. So in the end, those two were the only people in there. And I doubt there'd be a gun hidden in this room. Unless... The aunt? Could have done it? But no, that couldn't have been it either, because Mayo, the ghost in this case, said, I did it, I killed him. Oh my god.
So, Dr. Gray was shot with a gun, huh?
He was shot in the forehead.
But he was also stabbed in the chest with a knife.
A knife?
After being stabbed, the final blow was a shot from the gun.
Hey, let's examine.
Hey, pal, no touching without my permission. Just looking at it. Yeah, I can't be too careful of a kid like you. Her could be a murder suspect now, can I? Because if I want to search this room, I'm gonna have to come back later.
Let's, go to the other side.
Oh, fucking hell. Fine! Hmm, I'm pretty sure there was someone sleeping here earlier.
Hey, how can I help you?
What the fuck?
Heck, I'm like, so isn't it about time to start?
Huh? Time to start what?
You know, like the channeling.
Channeling?
Oh! No, actually, the situation has kind of changed.
Huh?
Like what do you mean?
Please stay calm, but a murder has taken place.
So, a murder is that thing where, like, one person kills another, right?
Yes, a person has killed another person.
Oh, that's... what are the words I'm looking for? It's like...
It's totally a bummer.
Yeah, after all that effort, that's all she had to say. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot to, like, introduce myself. My name is Inni.
You fucker! Who are you? That name came up at the start.
At the car. Oh.
So that's the person who probably introduced her to Dr. Gray. Wait, no, I'm going through the starting thing again. That was no accident. I was drugged with sleeping pills. He killed me, and that's why I got my revenge. Isn't that right, Inni? I think that's what it said. Did Inni do it? The way I'm seeing it, there's two possibilities. There could be a safe zone in the channeling room and Inni could have hid there. Or maybe there's two entry points. Like maybe there's a hidden door and Inni knew about it. Maybe. And Phoenix did say that someone was sleeping there. But what if it was like a pretend thing? You know how people can sneak out of their beds and put something in and make it look they're sleeping? It could be that. I don't know. Yeah. Parapsychology? Yeah, it's basically just paranormal stuff. That's right. I think people, like, usually call it occult studies or something. Like supernatural phenomenon, ESP and psychic powers. That sort of stuff. That's pretty out there. I'm Phoenix Wright, attorney at law. So what brings you here today?
I was the one who told Dr. Gray about this place. He asked me, like, do you know of a good spirit medium?
Ho, I know, it's this girl now. I got the perfect idea. So, the way I see it, Inni was friends with the... This is my hypothesis, by the way, other than how it went down. My guess is Inni was friends with the girl who died, and since this girl was learning in ESP, she probably contacted her friend and they made plans together for a past year. And so Dr. Gray showed her this place, so
when someone does the channeling, it will be great. The girl will finally be able to get her revenge by hosting someone and then killing Dr. Gray. But how I think it went down is Inni wanted to do the channeling, that's what I'm guessing. The Maya did it, and so they changed their plans a little. And instead, Maya got taken. The girl then stabbed Dr. Gray trying to kill him. Don't know where the knife came from. And then I'm thinking maybe Inni shot him from somewhere, but I'm not sure where. But there were two gunshots, that's the thing. There was two gunshots, but he was only shot once in the forehead. So I'm not sure what happened to the second gunshot. Dr. Gray did say something about being introduced to this place. Because, like, talking to dead people and, like, multiple personalities are my thing.
I see. Then why were you taking a nap here?
Like, I wasn't feeling good.
Huh?
I'm, like, allergic to sesame seeds. Like, must have been put some in the food they serve for lunch.
Oh, that doesn't sound fun.
So, I, like, felt sick and came in here to, like, sleep. I totally feel like I've wasted my time because I, like, slept a long time and I like saying like because I'm lying.
So, you were sleeping here the entire time?
Yeah, ever since lunch.
So, you don't know anything about the murder that took place?
Like, what? Oh, that. I, like, totally know nothing. So, who was, like, you know, killed?
The surgeon that requested the channeling. I shouldn't have showed him this place!
Dr. Gray knew each other, right? Oh my fucking god, this is just getting out of control. I don't know any Dr. Gray. Oh, really? That's not exactly what Dr. Gray said. like, a long, long time ago, I was, like, a patient, yeah. Sounds like she's trying to hide something.
Yeah. She sounds like that.
Have a look at my attorney badge! Like, I'm really sorry, but I'm not all that smart, so I don't, like, get it. Why does it feel like she's just putting on an act? Because she is. There's no one here, as usual. Ah, it's Pearly! Hey, how are you? Oh, it's Pearl. Okay, Pearly Pearl. You're Pearl, right? Silent as ever. What's that she's got in her hand? I've seen it somewhere before. So there has to be a second entrance. There can't be anything else. Maya wouldn't kill Dr. Gray. Or at least... that doesn't actually make sense because she was hosting... someone was hosting her. But, she was hosting someone, but still. She ran off. What is it? Is it my hair? Is it too spiky? Not spiky enough? Oh, boy. Let's go into the channeling room. Fuck you. Like, there's nothing. Fine. Let's go outside. She's probably scared out of her wits after having a murder take place right near her. Loda? God, don't let it be me next! Don't scare me like that! What do you mean? You're the one scaring me. If I weren't so tough, you'd have another dead body in your hands. Mine. Hey, mister. That gal, Maya. Wait, didn't I already do this? Yeah, I already went through all these. Any ideas? Did you see or notice anything that stuck out at you? Nah, well, maybe one thing. What is it? Turns out my poor stomach's not good at handling this kind of stuff. What? Curses and ghosts and stuff coming back to get you. This is just too much. What is that much? What is that much? Being an occult photographer. That's some scary stuff, so I think I'm gonna try being a celebrity photographer now. Alright, the photos are more within your reach from now on. More glamour, let's go. What's up? Oh, yeah. What is it? I took some hot pictures earlier. Huh? Remember I took some pictures in the murder scene? She did, too, even. The Seance murder. I sure like the ring of that. It'll be a sensational story. Luna! Sorry, but my journalistic sense is burning inside me. Hate to cut and run, but I'm heading back in. Gotta beat those two cops at the scoop of the century. I don't know who's scarier, Loda or the spirits. Why does it feel like we've been through this before? Oh boy. This is hilarious. Oh dear madam, you have such impeccable timing. Like, what's all the buzz?
Alright everyone, listen up. You too, pal. I'm gonna give you all a brief update. Right now, looks like the investigation is not going to be done until real late.
That is a terrible shame. I propose that everyone sleep here under the roof of the Fame Manor tonight. What a mess. I can't believe how crazy the day turned out. Mayor was arrested and taken away by the police, and I don't see myself getting any sleep tonight.
June 20, 8:02 a.m. Fame Manor, Meditation Room.
Morning. I guess I must have nodded off at some point.
Hurt Mayor's okay. Should hurry up and get to the detention center ASAP. June 20, 10:34 a.m. Detention center. Visitor's room. Nick! Mayor, what am I going to do? I never imagined it would turn out like this. Calm down, Mayor. Take deep breaths. Come to think of it, the first time I met her, It all started right here in this detention center. I remember that. I finally get to see you again, and it's not your fault. You didn't do it. And we already know you're innocent because you're in 2 months later. No, I did it. I killed that person. But that wasn't you. It doesn't matter. It might as well have been me. I was too weak, and I couldn't control the spirit's power, so I don't want to bring up the case quite yet, but you don't have to be nice to me, I understand. Fine. Channeling. So, you're the master or something of the Korean School of Channeling? Actually, my mother is for now, but since that title is passed from mother to daughter, I guess I will be someday. But many people think that channeling isn't real, and that it's all just an act. You believe in us, don't you? Yeah, because I've seen it with my own eyes. When Mei is channeling a spirit, not only her voice, but her whole physical appearance changes. Well, I wouldn't know about the voice because you don't fucking talk. It's a supernatural phenomenon that occurs every time. It happened this time, too. Dr. Gray said that he wanted to call the nurse, so Mei's body must have taken on that nurse's appearance. What exactly happened to the channeling chamber? I went into that room, but Dr. Gray locked the door and sat down across from me. Okay. We closed our eyes and I began the channeling. This is sounding kind of creepy, at the beginning of a scary story. And that's the last thing I remember. What? After a spirit comes to my body, I lose myself, my consciousness. Then you don't remember a single thing? When I came to, I was being held in my aunt's arms. And there was blood all over my clothes. Hmm? Oh, but I do remember having a dream. A dream? What dream? What kind of dream did you have while you were channeling? I can't remember it all that well, but I was dead and buried into the ground. I couldn't move and it was unbearable. Really suffocating. It went something like that. I see. I have no idea what to say to that. There was a really familiar smell too, under the ground. Yeah, I can't quite place it, but I know I've smelled that same scent before. Guess this is about all the information I'm going to gather for today. I'll be back later, Mayor. In the meantime, please make sure you prepare it, okay? Huh? It? What is it? The document requesting me to be your attorney, of course. But what's wrong? Are you sure? I mean, I'm guilty. I'm a murderer. No one's decided that yet. But I did, I killed that person with these two hands. Okay, this is just a guess, but her dream about under the ground, is that meant to be a hint to, oh, there's an underground passage into the channeling chamber? That's what I'm guessing at the moment. That's enough, Mayo. It's hopeless. If you defend me, you'll lose, I'm sure. Stop it. Help me. Nick, help me. I'm scared. Don't worry, I will. When it's trial. It sounds like tomorrow. As usual, zero prep time. Alright, I'm going now. Wait, this jewel, this is called a Magatama. It's a magical charm and it's always protected me. Give this to Pearly, and I'm sure she will lend you her spiritual powers. Pearl will finally talk to me! Yay! Hey, guess what? Guess what, Mayor? Guess what? Tony badge. Sorry, Nick, but there's nothing really special about it. Wow, you are a bitch. I'm not defending you. Game over. June 20, Korean Village. I have to save Maya, no matter what. It's her life on the line. What in the world happened to the room yesterday? Oh, Pearl. Will you talk to me, Pearl? The meditation room nurtures all mediums, young and old. Even mediums in training, I'd wager. But it's pretty deserted today. Probably because of the murder yesterday. Let's go to Channeling Chamber. June 20, Fey Manor, Channeling Chamber. At least the Detective Gumshoe isn't here today. I should take this chance and thoroughly check the room. If I'm lucky, I might uncover a clue or two. Hello! Oh, Mr. Wright. Good morning. I'm on my way to go meet Mystic Mayor, and I thought to bring her some items to make her feel at home. Namely, tea so bitter you lose your tongue and jaw-droppingly large strawberry desserts. I'm sure Maya will be very grateful. That's Mystic Maya, good sir! She's one scary lady. Oh dear, sweet Mystic Maya.
Pearl wept constantly for you last night, as did I. I know it's important for me to search the site, but I should ask her some questions too, while I have the chance. I would like to ask you a few questions about what happened yesterday. Do you mean that awful tragedy? That man murdered me, so I killed him. Leia? Step away from there! Please, leave this area to me! Go quickly and inform the police! What happened here in the room after I left? Well, first I struck Mystic Mayor on the head. To make her go unconscious, correct? That is correct. Next I performed the spirit severing technique. Spirit severing technique? The spirit of that nurse was inside of Mystic Mayor's body. I used that technique to send the nurse's spirit back to the other world. I wonder if this kind of testimony is even admissible in a court of your law. By the way, what is that room exactly? This room. The channeling chamber? This room was created for the sole purpose of preventing such a tragedy as yesterday. How do you mean? Sometimes when an experienced medium calls an especially strong spirit, that spirit may become violent and revolt as you witnessed yesterday. Revolt? But how? When a spirit enters a medium's body, she loses her will, and herself steps aside. Put it another way, the spirit is borrowing the medium's body, good sir. But isn't that extremely dangerous? An experienced medium has little problem controlling a spirit. Mystic Mayor, that was her first channeling. And that was why I insisted on locking the door. However, I never thought that would be calling danger upon the client himself. I am grateful that one of our heirlooms was not damaged in this horrible incident. And that is? It is that folding screen there. It is the Kurain's sacred white writings. Along with the Kurain's secret urn, they are the village's most treasured possessions. If I ever found out that something had happened to either one... inhumanity. What for her to be worrying about the folding screen at a time like this? I guess this isn't just some dilapidated old screen after all. So, how is Pearl today? Mr. Wright, yes? In this world, Pearl is my most treasured possession. When compared to even Mystic Mayor, Pearl has the spiritual power to become a master. That's very impressive. Until now, the women of the branch family have thought to themselves... be inferior, but Pearl is different. Her spiritual strength is so great, even greater than some of the main family. Yes, Pearl is a channeling prodigy, and is the pride of the branch family.
Wow, she's really fired up now.
In any case, our world is so different from yours, perhaps it is best for you to quit, good sir.
Quit?
Quit what?
I will not quit! I will never quit!
I will be leaving shortly to meet with Mystic Mayor. Simply do another time look at such trivial matters.
Okay.
Let's have a look at this. It's a beautiful and expensive folding screen. It also looks quite old. There seems to be some sort of sacred text written on it. But I can't read it. This is... it's a hole. Could this be made by a bullet?
I knew that was going to be important.
Well then, I do believe it is time for me to take my leave. Alright, please tell May I said hi.
What was that?
Mystic Mayor. I will tell her.
Sigh.
Okay, is there anything else I can make me examine? Just making sure, besides the door. The meditation room is on the other side of this very heavy-looking door. The lock on it is broken, because, well, I broke it. It doesn't seem possible, but I managed to break it pretty badly. When we want to do something bad enough, people can do the most amazing things.
This is where the medium site sits, I assume. There are four panels in this flooring. The straw in the flooring feels a little damp, probably from the humidity in the air. No matter what I do, my eyes keep getting drawn to that pool of blood in the center here. I guess this is an altar. Whatever it is, it feels very important. A mirror-like edge, object with a cloudy reflective surface. And some branches of a sacred tree have been set in predetermined arrangement. I guess they used during the channeling. There is some empty space behind the folding screen. The
The light of the candles can't reach back there, so it's completely dark. I hope no one is hiding back there. I got it! Okay, let's go to Windy Way. Winding Way. June 20, Fae Manor. Little Pearl isn't here today. Maybe she's at school. Let's have a look at things. Let's have a look at things. Small incinerator. Okay, I was hoping they'll say, oh, something's burnt there. Nope. Okay. Oh, hey! Like, you're that guy from yesterday. The, dentist guy. No, I'm a lawyer. That's right. Mr. Smith, Esquire. That's right. You're wrong. My name is Wright. Wow, they actually made that joke. Smith, Wright, well, I got like three letters. Did you? I. T. And H, okay. I don't think she gets the point. Anyway, why are you here? So, like, I studied this thing called parapsychology at the college, and, you told me about that yesterday. The Sesame Street elegy, too. What I'd like to know is why you're still here today. Oh, so, like, that's what you meant. Like, you should have been more, like, clear about it. Sorry, my bad. No, it's okay. Like, it's really... Oh, what? That's it? Why did you stop mid-sentence? Did I? So, like, what was I talking about? If literature ever wanted another genuine mysterious phenomenon, it's right here. Oh boy. She's sticking out her tongue. Oh my god. So, why are you still here today? Like, there's so much for me to, like, study here. Like what? The medium's training, or how they inherit their spiritual powers. I suppose this village is the real thing, after all. So, I asked if I could stay here for a little longer. She sure seems like the carefree type. At least on the surface. I'm just not gonna say the word like anymore. Have you heard about the murder? It's totally scary! She says with a silly smile plastered on her face. So do you know anything about it that might help? Somehow I don't think she has a grip on reality, let alone what's going on here. About the victim, Dr. Gray. I don't know who you're talking about. Wait, I think you asked about him, like, yesterday, too. That's right, her reaction yesterday when I asked was... I don't know, Mr. Gray. You and Dr. Gray knew each other, right? I don't know any Dr. Gray! Oh, really? That's not exactly what Dr. Gray said. Huh? Oh, well, like, a long time ago. I was, like, a patient, yeah. Okay, she's definitely hiding something from me. Like, is something wrong? Ooh boy. Let's examine the place. It's a small alcove. I have no idea what it's supposed to mean or symbolize. If I had one of these in the office, it would end up in storage space. But here it's decorated with some pretty flowers and a beautiful hanging scroll. That's a very nice place. Yeah, okay. So that's an alcove. Now where did this box come from? Sure this wasn't here last night. Looks like a box for storing clothes. But it's pretty big for just clothes. It's mostly empty, but a few folded pieces of channeling costume sit at the bottom. You left the blanket a mess. Are you gonna fold it? Like, I had a really good nap, and, like, I was thinking of leaving it like this, so, like, it's all set for tonight. That's what I do. This is the first time I've seen a sliding door like this in person. From here I can see the winding way and the little garden in the courtyard. Wow, seriously, it's your first time? That's sad. No clues here. Oh, there's a fucking thing over here. Seriously? There. It's a decorated wooden bear sculpture. There's a plate attached to the base. Korean village, the heart of channeling. What the? It's a souvenir. Isn't it cute? I, like, totally bought that. So it's yours, huh? Yeah, so, like, this village is really famous for, like, channeling and bears. Huh? Wait, famous for bears? But it's like, okay, if you ever, like, see a bear, you just play dead. And they, like, leave you alone. Is that right? Yeah, because, like, fighting back is totally no use. She actually tried to fight one. Land and way. Pearl! Ah! You surprised me. How are you today? Guess she isn't open to friendly chatting. Huh? She's still holding something in her hand. Looks like the same thing she had yesterday. I'm going to bridge, you might dare! Can you take a look at this, please? She's really scrutinizing my face. That's enough already. I'm not shifty looking, am I? I'm sorry, I had to do that. Oh yeah, May has said to give this to you. I'm in trouble now. If Morgan sees it like this, I'll be the next one that channeling. That's Mystic Mayas! Huh? She actually spoke. Who are you? I'm Phoenix Rad! You worked with my Mystic Mayor? You're Mr. Nick, right? Excuse me? I bet I know who she picked Nick up from. I know who you are. Wait, where did Nick come from? Phoenix? Like Nick at the end of that, I guess? Your Mystic May is special someone. Oh my god. So then, of course, you're going to have Mystic May, aren't you? That's what you're going to do, right? Well, yeah, I will. Oh, wow, it's just like a beautiful fairy tale. An earnest look shines brightly in your eyes. It must be true love. Why am I being boiled into a bright red lobster by this little kid? So jealous of Mystic Mayor. Ah, what a wonderful relationship. But wait, I mean, what are things aren't like? I can tell you're a good person. Right, Mr. Nick. I may be small, but I'm going to help you in any way I can. Oh, thank God. Pearl, are you friends with Mayor? I feel very grateful to be friends with her. She's so great. I want to be like Mystic Mayor when I grow up. You mean murder someone while channeling? Okay, that's a great future. I really look up to her. Wow, I had no idea Maya was so whatever. Usually, when people don't use Mystic Maya's title, I get mad. Sorry. But if it's you, Mr. Nick, then it's okay. Because you're special to her. I can just. Someone needs to take that picture of her face and do the Uno Gusai thing. If you know what I mean. Someone needs to do that. Where in the world did you get an idea like that? Oh my god. By the way, this may be rude, but which channeling school are you from?
Which channeling school?
Yes, for example, I studied the Korean technique. Ah, I get it. No, I'm a lawyer. Lawyer? Yep. Is that related to spirit mediums in any way? None that I know of. Wait, are you telling me you don't know what a lawyer is? I'm sorry, but I have no idea. Maria did say Pearl doesn't know much about the outside world. So, what's that you got in your hand, Pearl? Oh, this? I found it yesterday. If you want it, I can give it to you. Accept it. Alright, well, if you really want to give it to me. You look like a child at a toy store, Mr. Nick. She not only speaks in a refined manner, but laughs at one too. Black key. It has a jade emerald. That's it. Mr. Nick. Yes, Pearls? I can call you that, right? You're too cute just to call you Pearl. In comes the aunt yelling at us like, "You're hitting on my child!" Pearl, we need you to channel his dead body now. Sure, Mr. Nick. Are you sure it's okay for me to have the Magatama? Yeah, it's okay. I was told to give it to you. But I can't accept something like this. All I really should do is charge this Megatama with spiritual energy. Spiritual energy?
Whoa! Please take this. I'm sure it will be helpful.
What do you mean? It will let you see people's dark secrets.
Oh, this game's getting evil.
See people's secrets? Yes. if it's alright with you, I would like to accompany you for a little while. I can explain the Megatama's power to you when we meet someone hiding a secret.
What's your secret? Ooh, oh, okay. Oh, this is, I'm guessing I have to go to present and then present it to them or something. I'm not sure.
Meditation room!
June 20, Faye Manor, meditation room. Hey, it's you, pal. So, you're going to be her lawyer, I bet. Yeah. Oh, I really feel bad for you, pal. Just this once, I wish I could be on your side. Detective Gumshoe. Yeah, but I shouldn't be saying that kind of stuff to you. Hey, you're a cute kid.
I'm not scary. Honest.
Wow, I never knew Gumshoe liked kids. Hey, I know. I'll show you something cool. How's this? It's a real genuine pistol.
Detective Gumshoe, what are you doing showing her something dangerous? Oh, sorry.
Okay, let's look at what your secret is. What do you think about this? Hey, that's a pretty nice looking brooch. You should stop wearing that ugly old attorney's badge. Stop wearing that, pal. That detective is so nice. Aren't you happy, Mr. Nick? Happy? About what? Mayor's guilt. What about Mayor and the charges against her? I don't think you can win, pal. If you're talking about proof, we've got a few pieces. You got proof? Yeah, pal. The puffy head photographer is going to testify to her. You must be talking about Lota, actually. Speaking of Lota. I took some hot pics earlier. Huh? Remember? I took some pictures at the murder scene inside. Lota's hot pictures. I wonder what a camera captured. Besides, you must have realized by now, pal. There's no way anyone other than Mayor Faye could have done it. Am I supposed to say the pearls now? About Dr. Gray. The victim wasn't super famous, but people still knew who he was. His face was all over those tabloid shows last year. Yeah, I know. I was looking through some newspapers from last year and... Huh? I could have sworn I had cut an article out, but I guess I must have lost it. He's searching through his pockets and boy are those big. It looked really interesting too. Hey, do you have a copy, pal? Copy that article? I think Dr. Gray may have brought a copy to the office when he came by. About Mayor's trial tomorrow. I've got two pieces of news for you, pal.
Two?
Yeah, bad news and even worse news. So which reason do you want to hear first? I don't really care. It doesn't change the fact that I'm not going to like it. Alright, pal. Well, the prosecutor for the trial is prosecutor...
Fucking Von Karma! No! What? Von Karma? Manfred Von Karma. He was an awe-inspiring veteran prosecutor. He never lost a case in the 40 years of his career, and he raised a fearsome discipline. The horrible afterstate of the evil he force-fed me is something I'll never forget.
Wait a sec. Didn't Von Karma stand trial in? That's where the other piece of bad news comes in. Von Karma, you're facing tomorrow. It's actually his successor. Successor?
Ooh.
At least it doesn't have to be the other Von Karma. So, who is his successor? Literally, pal, it's prosecutor's Von Karma's kid. His kid became a prosecutor real young, like 13, and hasn't lost a trial since. That's what they call a prodigy, pal. Kid, huh? Wait a second. 13? The kid became a prosecutor at the age of 13? I mean, a prodigy like that, I would have heard something about. No. The kid was born and raised in Germany, pal. That country's got a lot of stuff and is a great place to develop a person's talent. Germany, huh? That's probably why I've never heard of this person. And he's probably gonna hate me for putting his father in prison. Oh, God. Still, all it takes is someone mentioning the name Von Karma. I get terrible flashbacks to that case.
Dune. Stop it! Get over it, Phoenix!
Person is already gone. Oh, whoops. No! I was going to say, that reminds me of a horror movie. So, yeah.
I'm guessing I'm not heading in there, then. Okay.
So, am I presenting something to her? Oh, I'd better shut my mouth.
About what? I'm not gonna give you any information about evidence, pal. Oh, fuck you. So, about this key. Hey, is that the house key or something, pal? Come on, does this look like a house key to you? Then what's it for? It's... actually, you should probably keep that a secret. It's my bicycle key. Oh, nothing special, huh? Oh. okay, Maybe I should, like, examine stuff? A piece of cloth with a ton of finely written characters generally put. Pretty, esoteric knowledge. Only mediums would know. Let's see. Here's one in English. It says 100 ways to save money. Being a medium sounds like a rough way of life. Interesting. June 20, Rad and Co. Law Officers. I need to get that magazine. Feels like I've been gone forever. But it's only been one day. Oh, that's right. Where's that newspaper Dr. Gray bought the other day? Ah, here it is, right on top of the desk. This is the only thing he left behind that's going to be any of any help. Newspaper clipping 1 added to the court record.
Now I can go present it to Detective Gamsho. Detective Gamsho. Yeah.
Dr. Gray brought this over to my office the other day. And, hey, it's that news story! The one about the malpractice suit. 14 patients died and it caused a huge stink. Yeah, but that's not all, pal. Things had only got worse after that. You mean the car accident that the nurse died in? Oh, here we go. I brought my own clipping with me today. Here, pal, this is for you. Alright, thanks. Didn't he lose it? Newspaper clipping 2. Mimi Mini, nurse at Gray Surgical Clinic, died after falling asleep. Oh, I better shut my mouth. But it's not evidence! Fine, let's move somewhere else. Okay, let's go see... Challenge Ember? No. Still not that... June 20, Detention Center, Visitor's Room. Maya must still be in questioning. I hope the detectives are taking it easy on her, but these kinds of cases aren't taking lightly. Guess I'll come back later. But I don't know where to go. I don't know where to go. I don't know where, I don't know where, I don't know where to go. I don't know where to go. I don't know where to go. Go, gotta go. What the hell? Thought I had to go in there. June 20, Fay Manor, side room. Hello again. We seem to be seeing a lot of each other today. Oh, she's like totally cute, is she? Like, your daughter? What? No! How do you think I am? Inny mini. Inny miny. Oh my god, you're kidding me. Inny miny. Wait, no. How does it go again? Something, something, mo. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Yeah, there it is. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. So, why are you still here today? Like, there's so much stuff for me to, like what? Oh, I already talked about all this. I want to ask you about the victim, Dr. Gray. I totally don't know him. Boom! What is that? You can see it, can't you, Mr. Nick? You can see the lock on the person's heart. Oh my... This...
this game... Huh? What?
This is the power of the Magatoma. Only you can see these Cyclops, Mr. Nick. Cyclops, huh? The more someone wants to hide their secret, the more locks you will see. If it's only one, I think you can easily unlock it. Unlock? But how? Please use Mystic Mayor's Magatoma on this person, and let's remove the lock. I have no idea what she's talking about, but guess I'll give it a try. You must be careful though, Mr. Nick. If you make a mistake, it will hurt you. If you don't think you have the proof you need, You must have the courage to stop.
Well, I've got to start somewhere. Let's give this Cyclone thing a try.
Boom!
I'm gonna ask you again, do you know Dr. Gray?
I totally don't know that guy. Like, you're totally more persistent than a roach.
Boom! This girl is hiding something. I'm sure of it. Because I have no choice but to remove this lock. Alright, so first, I have to use Mayor's Megatama. The victim.
Eeny meeny, I believe you do know who Dr. Gray is. I told you, like, how many times do I, like, have to repeat myself?
If you're, like, so totally sure, then where's, like, your proof?
Well, it may be possible that you never actually met Dr. Gray in person. I do believe you might have at least indirectly known of him.
Like, what do you mean? Like, indirectly?
You should try to show that possibility existed for now.
So something that shows a possible connection between Eeny and Dr. Gray.
1 year ago on May 2nd, 14 patients died from malpractice. Mimi Meany, nurse at Gray Surgical Clinic, died after falling asleep at the wheel.
Take that!
Take a look at this newspaper clipping.
Like, what is it? A story about an accident?
Please read the victim's name.
Mimi Meany.
Meany's a pretty rare last name, wouldn't you say? Miss Mimi Meany wouldn't happen to be a relative of yours, would she?
You noticed, she was my older sister.
I'm sorry about your loss.
Your sister, was she a nurse, perhaps at Dr. Gray's surgical clinic?
Gray's surgical clinic? I don't think I need to tell you that the clinic was run by the victim, Dr. Turner Gray.
Which is how you knew of Dr. Gray. You knew him through your sister.
Goodbye.
Unlock successful.
Please, tell me all you know about Dr. Gray. Yeah, she looks evil. Well, my sister, name was Mimi Meany. Eeny Meany. Miney. Oh my god, this is just... Mimi! She was like a nurse at Dr. Gray's clinic. That's what I thought. I heard that, like, Dr. Gray was really tough on people. Like, a total slave driver. My sis was, like, always coming home, totally wiped out because she was overworked.
Wiped out?
So is that why she fell asleep at the wheel? That guy, like, drove my sis so hard, so, like, that's why the accident happened.
The one where 14 patients died from malpractice?
Yeah, like, I think that was the doctor's fault, too. My sis was pushed by, like, everyone's expectations and, like, her duties and stuff. And that pushed her to her death.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So, like, are we done? I've, like, already told my story, too. Like, everyone.
Do you understand now, Mr. Nick? This is how a Cyclock works.
Well, I don't plan to pry into people's hearts unless I absolutely need to. The lock this time was pretty easy, but you might meet people who aren't as willing to give in later on. If you don't have enough proof, be careful and know when to stop trying.
Well, then, that was dramatic.
Hi. Okay, didn't mean to do that.
Okay then.
Let's go to Korean Village.
June 20, Korean Village.
Mr. Nick, what's wrong?
I've never left Korean Village.
Really? Wow, that's pretty amazing.
You were going to meet with Mystic Mayor, aren't you?
Please tell her I said hi.
Hey, wait! She ran off again. Well, I know any secret now, but I still don't have any idea how I'm going to save Mayor. I don't even know if I should go in there with a smile or with a straight face.
What am I supposed to do? I'm almost out of time. Can I really do anything? Can I really save her?
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Huh? Must be Mayor.
It's been a long time, hasn't it, Phoenix?
It's Mia.
It's Mia. Yep. She was scared. But Mia, even without me being here, it looks like you've learned to stand on your own.
This is just awesome. I love it when Mia shows up.
Mia, she's Maya's older sister and my mentor. She was a top-notch defense attorney, but a certain case forced her into a retirement. But whenever I'm in trouble, she comes to help, just like this.
Yeah, forced her into retirement, Cora, right?
Her spirit comes back from the other world and borrows Maya's body for a bit. Phoenix, you can't make that kind of face in front of your client. A lawyer is someone who smiles no matter how bad it gets, and especially when it's bad. Mia, you can't smile at the end if you haven't been smiling the whole way there. In any case, the face you're making now is no face to show a client, Phoenix. But so tell me all about it. I'm gonna guess that my sister is in a lot of trouble again? I told her everything about what had happened in the last 2 days. Mia closed her eyes deep in thought while she listened. She's not pissed. She's pissed, I mean. I see. Mia, what am I supposed to do? It's pretty clear what a good lawyer does in this situation. And that is, please tell me. Believe in your convictions. And fight for the complete acquittal of your client. Well, we get to talk to Mia. Nice. You think Mia's not guilty? How can you be so sure? I know she is. And I'll give you a hint as to why. Yes, mediums can't have dreams. Can't have dreams? From what she told me, it sounds like Maya was having a dream while channeling. Yeah, she said she dreamt that she had died and had been buried in the ground. But that is impossible. I've heard it from her, I'm sure. When a medium channels, her own spirit disappears. Which means that it's impossible for her to dream during that time. Then what does that mean? I think it's safe to bet that Maya was set up. Set up? It's up to you to blow the lid on this case tomorrow and show how she was set up. I knew it. Okay, first I thought her dream had to be a hint that there was an underground place, but no, I think Innie, who's also a good spirit channeler, hid behind the thingamajiggy, gassed Maya. She was probably already hosting the spirit, and she gassed the people in the room, making Maya fall asleep. And then she stabbed the guy, and then shot him. And I'm thinking that's what happened. And Innie doesn't care because it was her sister. How am I supposed to prove her innocence when I have nothing to go on? If you're looking for a clue, it's already in your hands. It is? Just as it sounds, Phoenix. You already had the key. Really? Come on, show me the key to this case. The key, huh? Alright, I'll show it to her. The key I hold.
The key is...
Oh, literally a key. Mia, have you seen this key before? Ah, the key. It's literally the key to understanding everything that's happened in this case. This key? Phoenix, listen, right now, that key is sitting in your hand. However, it shouldn't be. It contradicts the facts. What does she mean? I'm certain this key will be the place of evidence that makes your case tomorrow. It's saying there's an extra place into the room, I bet. You already know everything you need to know. You know what the key to the case is. That is enough. But how can I win tomorrow without knowing who the real murderer is? Who could have... At that time, I didn't know. This day was going to end with a turn for the surprise. For the surprising.
Ooh! What?
Mia? What? What's wrong? That's right, only I can see the Cyclops. Which means Mia must know something about the real murderer. For this to be something that she would hide under lock and key from even me. What in the world is going